Yeah. So first of all, I will ask you a few questions from the previous topics which we studied, and then we will go on for studying the Monera Kingdom. Okay, first of all, you tell me what were the modifications done by Karl Boos? That is Woese. What modifications were done by him? Sonu, Om, can you tell me the answer for this? But why? It's very easy. On the page number 83, it is written: kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. Are you having your book? Show it to me. It is on the page number 83, left hand side, just above the last para. Okay, one more question. What are the characteristics of fungi? Does anybody know? Then tell what are the characteristics of the fungi kingdom? What do you mean by symbiotic? What do you mean by symbiotic? Okay. Can you tell me the phylums of Plantae kingdom? Bryophyta. Yeah, correct. Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, Gymnosperms, and Angiosperms. Okay. So, shall we carry on then? If anybody wants to ask any question or any doubts in the topic, then you can ask. Otherwise, we will carry on our the topic Monera. Okay, so well then, we will carry on. These organisms do not have a defined nucleus or organelles. What do you mean by they do not have a defined nucleus? Which cell do not have a defined nucleus? Yeah, means it is prokaryotic, na? The organisms which are belonging to Monera kingdom, they are unicellular. First characteristic. Second characteristic, they are prokaryotic. That is, they do not have a well-defined nucleus region. On the other hand, they show diversity based on many other characteristics. Some of them have cell walls, while some do not. Of course, having or not having a cell wall has very different effects on the body design. Hear from having or not having a cell wall in multicellular organisms. The mode of nutrition in the organisms which are included in Monera kingdom are, they may be either autotrophic or heterotrophic. Means the organisms which are included in Monera kingdom, they may either have autotrophic mode of nutrition or they may have heterotrophic mode of nutrition. This group includes bacteria, blue green algae, or cyanobacteria and mycoplasma. And in the book, you can see the examples of the organisms which are included in Monera kingdom, bacteria and anabaena. Can you see in the book? Yeah, you have to draw these two diagrams which are belonging to the Monera kingdom. First of all, you will write the characteristics. First, unicellular organisms. What is the first characteristic? The organisms which are included in Monera kingdom, they are unicellular. Second characteristic, they are prokaryotic. Third, they may have cell wall or the cell wall may be absent in them. Fourth characteristic, mode of nutrition in organism can be either autotrophic or heterotrophic. What do you mean by autotrophic mode of nutrition? What do you mean by? What do you mean by heterotrophic mode of nutrition? What do you mean by heterotrophic mode of nutrition? Yeah, the organisms which depend on other organisms like plants or animals for obtaining food, that are heterotrophic. So the organisms which are included in Monera kingdom, they may be either autotrophic or heterotrophic. So what are the five characteristics we studied in Monera kingdom? First one, unicellular, correct. Second, prokaryotic. Third, cell wall may be present or absent. Yeah, correct. Fourth one, mode of nutrition may be autotrophic or heterotrophic. Examples, if we take bacteria, blue green algae. Okay, next one is Protista kingdom. This group includes many kinds of unicellular eukaryotic organisms. The first characteristic you can write with your pencil, they are only in the book. First characteristic of the Protista organisms, the organisms which are included in Protista kingdom, the first characteristic is that they are unicellular. Organisms belonging to Protista kingdom, they are unicellular. Means made up of one cell. Second one, they are eukaryotic. In Monera we saw these are prokaryotic. Okay na? The organisms which are included in Monera, they are prokaryotic. And the organisms which are included in Protista kingdom, they are eukaryotic. What are eukaryotic organisms? The cell in which the nuclear region is well defined, that is, it has a nuclear membrane around it. That is called eukaryotic cell. And the organisms are called eukaryotes. Some of these organisms use appendages, such as hair-like cilia. Cilia is used by paramecium, or whip-like flagella for moving around. Their mode of nutrition can be autotrophic or heterotrophic. So this is the fourth characteristic which we got. The mode of nutrition in Protista, it may be autotrophic or heterotrophic. Okay na? First characteristic in Protista kingdom is what? They are unicellular organisms. Second characteristic of Protista organisms, they are eukaryotic organisms. Third characteristic, organisms uses appendages for showing movements. Fourth one, mode of nutrition can be autotrophic or heterotrophic. Okay. Examples you can take, algae, protozoa, paramecium, amoeba. On the page number 84, you can see the examples of the organisms are drawn. And these you have to draw in your fair note. The diagram of paramecium, amoeba, and the euglena. The third kingdom is stated by the Carl, that is fungi. These are heterotrophic eukaryotic organisms. So the first characteristic we got in fungi kingdom is what? These are eukaryotic. Eukaryotic means having a well-defined nuclear region. Second one, they are heterotrophic. Means the mode of nutrition is heterotrophic. But in Monera and Protista, it may be either heterotrophic or autotrophic. Correct na? Talk about in Monera or Protista organisms, they may have autotrophic or heterotrophic mode of nutrition. But in fungi, these are only having heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Why? Because they feed on dead and decaying food material. And therefore, they are called saprophytes. Some of them use decaying organic material as food and are therefore called saprotrophs. Others require a living protoplasm of a host organism for food. You know who is a host? Who is a host? Can you tell me the answer for this question? Who is a host? The organisms that obtain food from other organisms' body. They suck the blood. Correct, na? Like parasites. These all organisms are called parasites, which suck the blood or obtain the food from other organisms' body. Like leeches, mosquito. These are the examples of parasite. Many of them have the capacity to become multicellular organisms at certain ages in their lives. They have cell walls made of a tough complex sugar called chitin. Underline it. What is chitin? Cell walls made up of a tough complex sugar that is called chitin. And these can be seen in fungi organisms. Example, if we take yeast, molds and mushrooms. Any of the two diagrams you can draw in your note. Then, some fungal species live in permanent mutually dependent relationships with blue-green algae or cyanobacteria. Means the organisms which are mutually dependent on the environment, and environment is also dependent on the organism, like the microbes which are present in the soil. They help in increasing the fertility of the soil. So these are called symbiotic. And the relationship between the organism and the environment, which makes them mutually dependent on each other, that is called symbiotic relationship. These symbiotic life forms are called lichens. We have all seen lichens as the slow growing large colored patches on the bark of trees.